हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एस्पायर डॉक्टर। दिस इज डॉक्टर नमिता। होप यू आर डूइंग ग्रेट। इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियोस वी कवर्ड रूट, स्टेम, लीफ इन द चैप्टर ऑफ मॉर्फोलॉजी ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स। इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इन्फ्लोरेसेंस एंड फ्लावर। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द टॉपिक इन्फ्लोरेसेंस। व्हाट इज इन्फ्लोरेसेंस? इन्फ्लोरेसेंस इज द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ फ्लावर्स ऑन द फ्लोरल एक्सिस। It is of two types, racemos and cymos. In racemos, the main axis continues to grow and do not terminate a flower. You can see here, this is the main axis. As it continues to grow, it forms flowers. So the first formed flowers are oldest flowers are at the base of the pedicel, and the newly formed flowers are the younger flowers which are formed at the apex. This type of arrangement in which older flowers are at the base and younger flowers are at the apex is called as acropetal order. Coming to the cymos, the main axis terminates into a flower. In cymos, the inflorescence is of limited growth. As the main axis terminates into a flower, you can see here, the main axis terminates into a flower and the younger flowers are formed to the base of the older flowers. So from this you can say the younger flowers are at the base of the pedicel and the older flowers are at the apex of the pedicel. This type of arrangement in which younger flowers are at the base and older flowers are at the apex is called as basipetal order. Next, coming to flower. Flower is a reproductive unit in angiosperms. Flower is an organ for sexual reproduction in the flowering plants. Flower has four roles arranged successively on swollen end of stalk or pedicel called thalamus or receptacle. You can see here, this is a stalk or pedicel on which a swollen structure is present. This swollen end is called as thalamus or receptacle. The floral appendages are arranged on this thalamus in the form of four rolls. They are calyx, corolla, anrisium and gynoecium. Calyx is also called as sepal, corolla is called as petal, and anrisium is also called as stamen, and gynoecium is also called as carpel. So these floral appendages are arranged in the form of four rolls on the receptacle or thalamus, which is attached to stalk, that is pedicel. Here you can see bracts that are present at the base of the pedicel. Bracts are reduced leaves found at the base of the pedicel. In some flowers, the bracts are present, and some flowers bracts are absent. The flowers with bracts are called as bracteate, and the flowers without bracts are called ebracteate. The four floral appendages of flower are calyx, corolla, anrisium and gynoecium. Calyx and corolla are called as accessory organs, and anrisium and gynoecium are reproductive organs. Generally, accessory organ means they assist in the main function of the other organs. Here, in case of flower, these calyx and corolla assist in the main function of reproduction. So the calyx and corolla in some plants are indistinct. They are together called as perianth. The calyx and corolla are not differentiated in perianth. Example of perianth is lily. In lily we can't differentiate calyx and corolla. Coming to the anrisium and gynoecium, these are reproductive organs of the flower. If a flower has both anrisium and gynoecium, it is considered as bisexual flower. If the flower has either one, that is either anrisium or gynoecium, it is considered as a unisexual flower. I hope you are clear till now. Coming to the next point, a flower is a modified stem or shoot. Here the shoot apical meristem is developed into a floral meristem. In case of floral meristem, the axis is condensed and internodes do not elongate. Here you can see, this is a shoot apical meristems and these are leaves which are formed at the nodes. This shoot apical meristem is converted into the floral meristem, which produce the floral appendages. What do you mean by floral appendages? Floral appendages means calyx, corolla, antrisium and gynecium. So at nodes, different floral appendages are laterally produced from the apex. Instead of leaves at nodes, floral appendages are formed. When a shoot tip develops into a flower, it is always solitary. Here you can see the shoot tips develops into a flower which is solitary, that means alone, it is single. I hope you are clear till now. Coming to the next topic, symmetry. What is meant by symmetry? If we divide a substance through a particular plane, the resultant halves should be identical and mirror images. Such halves are said to be symmetrical. Coming to the types of symmetry in a flower, it is of three types: actinomorphic, zygomorphic and asymmetric. Actinomorphic is also called as radial symmetry and zygomatic is also called as bilateral symmetry, and asymmetric is also called as irregular symmetry. In actinomorphic, a flower can be divided into two equal halves in any plane passing through the center. You can see here it can be divided into two equal halves in any plane, but it should pass through the center. This type of symmetry is called as actinomorphic or radial symmetry. You can remember this through assuming a circle. Assume it as a flower. This is divided into identical halves through the radius of the circle. So as it is divided through the radius, it is called as radial symmetry. The examples of actinomorphic are mustard, datura and chili. Coming to the zygomorphic symmetry, it is also called as bilateral symmetry. The flower can be divided into two similar halves only in one particular plane passing through the center. So this is a flower. You can divide this into two equal halves only in one particular plane. If you divide this flower through this plane, equal halves are not formed. The examples of zygomatic symmetry are pea, bean, cassia and gulmohar. Asymmetric or irregular. The flower cannot be divided into two similar halves by any vertical plane through the center. Example of asymmetric is kanna. As I said before, examples in this chapter are very important. So let's revise the examples again. Examples of actinomorphic symmetry are mustard, datura and chili. And further, zygomatic symmetry are pea, bean, cassia and gulmohar. For asymmetric, kanna. Next, coming to the topic, position of floral parts on thalamus. Based on this, the flowers are divided into hypogynous, perigynous and epigynous. Coming to the hypogynous, the gynecium occupies the highest position and other parts are situated below it. You can see in this diagram, this is the gynecium. It occupies the highest position than other floral appendages. This occupies the highest position and the antrisium, corolla and calyx are situated below this. This type of ovary is called as superior. Examples of hypogynous are mustard, china rose and brinjal. Coming to the perigynous, the gynecium is situated in the center. Other parts are located on the rim of the thalamus. Here the ovary is half inferior or half superior. The gynecium is located in the center and other parts are at the rim of this is the thalamus. Other parts are present at the rim of the thalamus. Examples of perigynous are plum, rose and peach. Coming to the epigynous, the margin of thalamus grows upward and encloses ovary completely and get fused with it. other parts arise above the ovary. Here you can see this is a thalamus. The margins of thalamus grows upward and it encloses the ovary completely and it gets fused with the other parts, that is sepals, corolla and andrecium. Here the ovary is present inferior to the other parts, so it is called as inferior ovary. Examples of epigynous are guava, cucumber, ray florets of sunflower. You can also remember things in this way. Hypogynous means you can divide this word into hypo and gynous. All the structures are present below the gynecium. Hypo, below the gynecium. You can see here all the structures are present below the gynecium. As it is present superior to the other parts, it is called a superior ovary. Coming to the perigynous, the gynecium is surrounded by the other structures almost at the same level. This type of ovary is called half inferior ovary or half superior ovary. Coming to the epigynous, other structures are present above to the gynecium, so it is called as epigynous. You can see here other structures are present above to the gynecium, so it is called epigynous. And here the ovary is below to the other structures, inferior to the other structures, so it is called as inferior ovary. Also remember these examples: mustard, China rose and brinjal for hypogynous, plum, rose and peach is for perigynous, guava, cucumber and ray florets of sunflower is for epigynous. Next, coming to the types of flowers, it is of three types: trimerous, tetramerous and pentamerous. In trimerous, the floral appendages are multiples of three. What do you mean by floral appendages? The calyx, corolla, andrecium and gynecium are called as floral appendages. These floral appendages are present in the multiples of three. You can see here these are calyx, corolla, andrecium and gynecium is present within this. These are present in the three or in multiples of three. Coming to the tetramerous, floral appendages are present in multiples of four. Coming to the pentamerous, here the floral appendages are present in the multiples of five. Coming to the parts of flower, the outermost roll of the flower is calyx. The members of calyx are called as sepals. The sepals are green and leaf-like structures. The main function of sepal is to protect the flower in bud stage. The calyx is of two types: gamosepalous and polysepalous. In gamosepalous, the sepals are united to form single structure. In polysepalous, the sepals are free. You can see here, this is gamosepalous and this is polysepalous. Here the sepals are united to form a single structure. Here the sepals are free, so it is called as polycephalous. Coming to the next part, corolla. Corolla is the second roll of the flower. The members of corolla are called as petals. Petals are bright colored. The main function of petals are is to attract the insects for pollination. Corolla varies in colors and shape. Coming to the shape, it is tubular, bell-shaped or funnel or wheel-shaped. The corolla is also arranged in two types: gamopetalous and polypetalous. Gamopetalous means united petals. Polypetalous means free petals. You can see here this is polypetalous. All the petals present are free and they are not united. You can see in this diagram, gamopetalous, they are fused to form a single unit. This type is called as gamopetalous, means united petals. I hope you are clear till now. Coming to the next topic, aestivation. What is aestivation? It is a mode of arrangement of petals or sepals in floral bud with respect to other members of same role. There are four types of aestivation: valvate, twisted, imbricate, vexillary. Coming to the valvate, the sepals or petals in a role just touch each other at margins. They do not overlap. You can see here, the margins are about to touch, but they do not overlap. This type of arrangement is called as valvate aestivation. Example of valvate aestivation is Calotropis. Coming to the twisted aestivation, the margins of petals or sepals overlap the next one. Here they do not overlap, but in this case, each sepal or petal overlaps the next one. Example of twisted aestivation is China rose, lady's finger and cotton. Next, coming to the imbricate aestivation, if margins of sepals or petals overlap one another, but not in any particular direction. In imbricate also, overlapping takes place like in twisted, but here it follows a particular fashion. But in imbricate aestivation, any particular direction is not followed. They are irregularly overlapped by other. Example of imbricate aestivation is Cassia and Gulmohar. Coming to the vexillary or papillonaceous, this type of aestivation has 5 petals. The largest petal is the standard petal. This standard petal overlaps the 2 lateral petals which is present below the standard petal. These lateral petals are called as wings. These lateral petals overlap the 2 smallest anterior petals which is called as keel. You can see in this diagram, this is a standard petal and this is the largest one. This standard petal overlaps the lateral petals, that is wings. This lateral petals overlap the keel, that is two smallest anterior petals. They are fused to form a single one. This is called as keel. Example of vexillary aestivation is pea and bean. I hope you are clear till aestivation. Next, coming to the topic, anrisium. Anrisium is composed of stamen. The stamen is a male reproductive organ. If a stamen in a flower is sterile, it is called staminode. The parts of stamen are stalk or filament and an anther. You can see here, this is a stamen, this is a filament and this is anther. Coming to the stalk of filament, variation is seen in length of the filament within a flower. Example is mustard and salvia. Coming to the anther, usually the anther is bilobed. Each lobe has 2 chambers. These chambers are called as pollen sacs. These pollen sacs produces the pollen grains. You can see in this diagram, this is an anther. This is bilobed. Each lobe contains 2 chambers. These chambers are called as pollen sacs and this pollen sac contain pollen grains. I hope you are clear till now. Coming to the types of stamens, it is of 2 types. When stamens are united with other parts and when stamens are united among themselves. When stamens are united with other parts, 2 types are present: epipetalous and epiphyllous. Epipetalous means stamens attached to petals. As the name suggests, epipetalous, stamens are attached to petals. Example is brinjal. You can see here, this is calyx, this is calyx, this is corolla, and this is stamen and this is gynoecium. Here the stamens are attached to corolla, that is petal. So it is called as epipetalous. Coming to the epiphyllus, the stamens are attached to perianth. Perianth means the calyx and corolla together forms perianth. In perianth, the calyx and corolla are not distinguished. They look alike. Example is lily. Coming to the next type, when stamens are united among themselves, three types are formed. Monoadelphous, didelphous and polydelphous. Mono means the stamens are united to form single bundle. You can see here, this is single staminal bundle that is formed by many stamens. Example of monoadelphous is China rose. Coming to the didelphous, di means two. The stamens are united to form two bundles. You can see here, this is one bundle and this is one. So this type of arrangement is called didelphous. Example of didelphous stamen are P. Coming to the polyadelphous, the stamens are united into more than two bundles. You can see here, more than two bundles are formed. Examples of polyadelphous is citrus. With this we completed calyx, corolla and anrisium. Now coming to gynoecium, it is a female reproductive part. You can remember this way. G means girl, is a female. So gynoecium is a female reproductive part. The gynoecium is made of one or more carpel. The parts of carpels are ovary, style and stigma. You can see here, this is ovary, this is style and this is stigma. Ovary is the enlarged basal part, bears one or more ovules attached to a flattened cushion like placenta. You can see here, this is a ovary. It is an enlarged basal part. It is present at the base, so it is enlarged basal part. It bears one or more ovules. This ovary contains one or more ovules. This ovule is attached to a cushion-like placenta. Next, coming to the style, it is an elongated tube on the ovary. It connects ovary and stigma. This is style. It connects ovary and stigma. Next, coming to the stigma, it is present at the tip of the style. It is a receptive surface for pollen grains. The pollen grains come and attach to this receptive surface of the stigma. Coming to the types of gynoecium, when carpels more than one are present, two types of gynoecium is seen, apocarpous and syncarpous. In apocarpous, carpels are free. You can see in this diagram, the carpels are free. They are not attached. Examples of apocarpous are lotus and rose. Coming to the syncarpous, carpels are fused. You can see here, the carpels are fused. Three carpels are fused to form a single one. This is called as syncarpous. Example is mustard and tomato. Examples of apocarpous is lotus and rose. Examples of syncarpous is mustard and tomato. I hope you are clear till now. Coming to the next topic, placentation. What is placentation? Placentation is the arrangement of ovules within the ovary. See, this is an ovule. The arrangement of ovules within an ovary is called as placentation. These are ovules and this is ovary. So the placentation is of five types: marginal, axial, parietal, free central and basal. Coming to the marginal placentation, the placenta forms a ridge along the ventral suture of the ovary. What is a placenta? Placenta is a cushion-like structure to which ovules are attached. It is a placenta to which ovules are attached. So in marginal placentation, the placenta forms a ridge along the ventral suture of the ovary. Here the ovules are born on the ridge. This is the ridge and the ovules are born on the ridge, following the two rows. When we open this, we can see two rows of ovules are arranged in the ovary. Example is peas. Coming to the axial placentation, the placenta is axial. The placenta is axial means it is present at the center. The placenta is present at the center, at the axis. The ovules are attached to the placenta in a multilocular ovary. Here the ovules are attached to this placenta in a multilocular ovary. What is multilocular ovary? The ovule is divided into many locules by septum. This is called as multilocular ovary. This space is called as locule. As there are many locules present, it is called as multilocular ovary. So, in axial placentation, the placenta is at axial and the ovules are attached to the placenta at the axis in a multilocular ovary. Examples are China rose, tomato and lemon. Next, coming to the parietal placentation, the ovules develop on the inner wall of ovary or peripheral part. You can see this, the ovules are formed on the inner part of the ovary or peripheral part. Ovary is single chambered, but due to the formation of false septum is formed in this way. Two chambers are formed. Examples of parietal placentation is mustard and argemon. Next, coming to the free central placentation, the ovules are present on the central axis. The septa is absent. As the name suggests, free means only one locule is present. No septa is present to divide the ovary into locules. Here you can see in this diagram, this is a unilocular ovary and only one locule is present and there is no septa. The ovules are present at the central axis. The examples of free central placentation are dianthus and primrose. Coming to the basal placentation, the placenta is present at the base of the ovary. Single ovule is attached to this placenta, which is present at the base of the ovary. The examples of basal placentation is sunflower and marigold. I hope you are clear with the placentation. With this, I completed the topic inflorescence and flower. I simplified these topics to make you to learn easily. Examples in this chapter are very important. Memorize the examples by remembering the diagrams. So just revise the examples well. Thank you for watching the video. If you like the video, please do like, share, subscribe and click bell icon to get notified. If you want me to explain any topic you feel difficult, please comment below. And if you want me to explain any doubts also, please comment below. I am ready to explain those doubts in the next videos.